Let's go over this again. I want to get a clear picture before forensic shows up.
Well, you know most of it. I came in, Cyril was dead, and apparently of asphyxiation.
Because somebody pulled the plug on the respirator.
Actually, the switch was on. It would be running if it had been plugged in.
So whoever did it had to know how to turn off the alarm. Is that difficult?
No, actually, it's very simple. You simply take a tongue depressor and you push it down right there.
Is it unusual to suspend it?
No, it's done in procedures all the time, and once in a blue moon, someone will forget to turn it back on.
Who's in charge of the alarm? The nurses?
Yes, but any moderately trained health professional would know the basic knowledge there.
What about the pulse simulator?
That takes more knowledge, because Sorrell's EKG leads were attached to the simulator, and that way the flat line didn't show at the ICU desk monitor.
So we're talking doctors, nurses, technicians. What about lay people?
That would just require a little bit more basic research. I'm not much help, am I?
You know, there's one thing I don't get, Doctor. If you knew how to disable the alarm, why not turn off the respirator? Why unplug it?
That would show an unfamiliarity with all the procedures.
Or maybe you just want to throw us off our track.
Or...
what?
Someone wanted to make damn sure that Sorrell was dead.